more distally in comparison to the lateral. Ano ibig sabihin to na? So the medial, tingnan nyo to, no? Yung medial ay mas malaki and yung medial extends more distally. So in short, the tibial plateau, if you fix the tibial plateau, you don't want to have a straight line, no? Kasi hindi naman yun yung normal na articular surface niya, no? So pag gumawa tayo, Gwen, so the medial plateau is lower than the lateral. Kasi nga, the medial femoral condyle is larger than the lateral condyle. No? So that's one technique also. That's one technique also when reading the MRI. No? So in order for you to know if it is the lateral condyle or the medial condyle, is of course number one, you look at the fibula, di ba? Kasi the fibula is always on the lateral side. If you cannot see the fibula, kasi there are certain cuts na the fibula is not yet visible, di ba? So if you cannot see the fibula, you look at the articular surface, no? The one lower, that's the medial. Kasi nga, the medial femoral condyle is larger, no? And extends more distally. Ang nangyari? Ayos. So doon sa recorded video, may Netflix na lalabas. Ano upuan ko? Ah, sorry, sorry. So mag-search ulit, mag-share ulit ako. Mamaya. Mamaya. Malakayan pa ba natin yan? Okay. Okay. So we have a separate lecture, no, for ACL, PCL, meniscus, no, pero this is a background lang, no. So the ACL, anterior cruciate ligament, resist anterior displacement of the tibia on the femur, no. And they said that ACL, no, according kay Snell, no, sabi niya yung ACL daw provides 70% of the anterior stability, no. It prevents kasi anterior displacement. That's the primary function, no. Pero yung ACL has a secondary function, and the secondary function is to resist varus, no, to resist varus displacement, no. That's the secondary function, no, resist varus displacement. Pero the primary is to resist the anterior displacement of tibia on the femur. Remember that it's intrasynovial, no, for those of you na nakakita na ng reconstruction, di ba? Hindi naman kita kaagad yung ACL because it is covered within synovium, no. The origin is the lateral femoral condyle, and the insertion is anterior and between the intercondylar eminence. Okay, so what I want you to remember is the size. No, the size is 33 by 11. The size is 33 by 11. Kaya nga, when we do ACL reconstruction, the minimum diameter is 8 millimeter. No? Kasi the native size is 33 by 11. No? So, with two bundles, no, anteromedial as well as the posterolateral bundle. No, written sa book, anteromedial bundle is tight both in flexion and extension, no? Both in flexion and in extension, tight yung anteromedial bundle. But for examination purposes, anteromedial bundle is tight in flexion, okay? Posterolateral bundle is tight in extension, and the main blood supply is the middle geniculate artery. Okay? So, di ba, if you can imagine, there are three structures inside the knee, di ba? So you have the both meniscus in each side. So medial, sa medial meniscus, lateral, lateral meniscus, and you want the one in the middle, ACL and PCL. So for you to easier to remember, remember that the middle structure, the blood supply is middle also, no, middle geniculate. Yung medial meniscus, edi medial then medial geniculate. Yung lateral, edi lateral then lateral geniculate. And all of the geniculate arteries arises from the popliteal artery. No? Di ba popliteal artery is a continuation of what artery nga? Edi femoral. No? Femoral artery, di ba, pupunta sa likod, magiging popliteal. From the popliteal, doon manggagaling yung mga geniculate. And one of them is the middle geniculate. So posterior cruciate, no, resist posterior tibial displacement. The origin is the medial femoral condyle, no. So bakit kaya naka-bold all caps yung insertion, no? Kasi lumabas ng 2023 ITE, di ba? Insertion posterior depression on the intercondylar eminence, no? Also known as PCL fossa, ha? Lumabas last year, no? The size is 38 by 13. In short, PCL is larger than the ACL. ACL kasi is ilan nga? 33 by 11. PCL is 38 by 13. Blood supply is medial geniculate. No? Medial geniculate. From the popliteal artery also. So, menisco femoral ligament, you have two, no, ligament of Humphrey and ligament of Risbert, no, as you can see on the picture on your right. So both of them arises from the posterior horn of the lateral meniscus, no, so dun siya galing, posterior horn ng lateral meniscus, and they will insert together with the PCL, yung isa sa harap, yung isa sa likod. Sino yung sa harap? Lagi natin sinasabi, ligament of Humphrey, no, starts with the letter H. Kaya siya yung nasa harap ng PCL. Ligamento Risbert, siya yung nasa likod, no? Menisco femoral ligament. Next is the lateral collateral ligament, also known as the fibular collateral ligament. It resists varus displacement at 30. No? Lumabas, no? It resists varus displacement at 30 degrees. So in short, if you want to isolate yung LCL, you do the varus stress test at 30 degree of knee flexion. Kasi if you do the varus stress test at full extension, you are testing the ACL and the LCL. Diba we said kanina, the secondary function of ACL is to prevent varus. So if you want to isolate LCL, you don't do varus stress test at full extension. You do it at 30 degree of knee flexion. Origin is lateral femoral condyle, insertion is fibular head, no? So later, no, I'll show you yung different structures connected sa fibular head. So medial collateral ligament, it resists naman valgus angulation. If you want to isolate ulit the MCL, you do valgus stress at 30. Kasi at full, you're testing the PCL naman. No, I forgot to say kanina, no, secondary function of PCL is to resist valgus displacement. With two components, superficial and deep. So if matandaan nyo, di ba, pag nag-harvest tayo ng graft, ng gracilis and hamstring, may nakikita kayo na iiwan na kulay puti sa loob. So that's the superficial MCL, no? While yung deep MCL, it blends with the capsule, no? The main stabilizer for valgus displacement at any angulation, no, any degree of knee flexion is the superficial MCL, no, that's the primary stabilizer for against valgus stress. While see deep MCL, it will resist valgus stress at full knee flexion, no, at full knee flexion. So yung primary is superficial. So posterolateral corner resists posterolateral rotation of tibia on the femur. Components are the following. LCL, popliteus. Dito pala, no? dito sa, oops, sorry. Paano ko ba ito balik? Dito, no, yung sa fibular head, di ba, sabi ko sa inyo, from anterior to posterior, ang mnemonic natin dyan, LPB, LPB, League of Philippine Basketball, no, LPB, from anterior to posterior, L stands for LCL, P stands for popliteofibular ligament, LPB, B stands for tendon ng biceps. And the most posterior is the common peroneal nerve. Pero, hindi siya attached sa fibular head. Siya lang yung the most posterior structure, pero not attached to the fibular head. Why? Because common peroneal nerve will go sa femoral neck. Ay, sa fibular neck, di ba? So, if they ask you, mga naka-insert, tatlo, LPB. Pero yung mga structure, apat, the most posterior, common peroneal. So, posteromedial corner, important for rotatory stability, and that's the composition. Dito nga pala, no, I forgot, no, sa posterolateral corners, you can see, no, they are inserted sa fibular head. Kaya, if you can still remember last year, di ba, we reconstructed the posterolateral corner. Saan ko ba inattach? Sino ba kasama ko noon? Saan ko ba inattach yung fibular sling? Sa fibular head. Kasi nandun yung attachment niya. No? Tapos naglusot ako ng parang triangular na semitendinosus. So meron sa harap, meron sa likod. Kasi sa harap, it will represent the LCL. Yung nasa likod na triangle will represent the popliteofibular. Next is the ALL for rotational stability, no? So this is the reason. So this is the reason why we do yung LET, 'di ba? Yung lateral extraarticular tenodesis, no? There are multiple journals saying promising result, 'di ba? Excellent outcome. It's because of the anterolateral ligament. Kasi it protects your graft, no? It protects your graft. So, ano nga yung second? If you see a fracture where? Lateral or medial tibial plateau? Ayun o yung nasa picture, oh. Di ba? Fracture at the proximal tibial plateau, a chip fracture there, you call it second. Ano ba ibig sabihin ng second? Patog mnemonic for ACL tear. Pero magtataka ka, ACL is nasa central structure ACL. Pero yung second nasa gilid. Pero bakit siya patog mnemonic sa ACL tear? It's because of the anterolateral ligament. So, before you transect the ACL, you need to injure the ALL first. No? So, kung merong nasa lateral, anong tawag dito? Pag yung chip fracture nasa lateral proximal tibial plateau, ang tawag second. Kapag nasa medial pero femoral, anong tawag nga dyan? Pellegrini striata, no? Ang ibig sabihin naman, di ba, neglected MCL tear, no? So, difference ng dalawa, ha? So, ano yung mga must know examination? So, for ACL, you have three, anterior drawer, Lachman, pivot shift. The difference between anterior drawer and Lachman, you do anterior drawer at 90 degrees, you do Lachman at 30 degrees. The anterior drawer will test the anteromedial bundle. The anterior drawer and the Lachman will test the anteromedial bundle. The pivot shift will test the posterolateral bundle. Kaya nga, ano yung isang test for us to know if we do LET or not? Anong sagot doon, Carlos? Kasi, di ba, si LET will reconstruct the ALL. ALL ang function rotatory. If you want to test the rotatory stability, what do you want to test? The AM or the PL? The PL bundle. Kasi nga, yung AM bundle, ang primary purpose nun is anterior translation. Yung PL, rotation. So, if you want to test the PL, you do pivot shift. So PCL, you have two, posterior sag sign and posterior drawer sign. The LCL and the MCL, you listen, no? Ito medyo nakakalito, di ba? So if you have a patient, you do varus stress, positive ka, positive is meaning there's opening, di ba? Or there's pain. No? Kapag positive ka at 0 degree of varus, meaning you have injury of both ACL and LCL. Pero if you repeat the test and you do it at 30 degree, positive ka pa rin to both ACL and LCL. No? Pero ulit ha, if you do the virus stress, negative ka at 0, positive ka at 30, ano ibig sabihin nun? Ha? Ano sabi natin kanina? If you want to isolate LCL, you do it at what degrees? 30. So ulit ha, if you do the virus stress, negative ka at 0, positive ka at 30, ano ibig sabihin? LCL. L pa eh, na nag-resist. Pero kapag positive ka sa 0, positive ka sa 30, ano ibig sabihin nun? Both ACL and LCL. Kapag 30 lang, LCL lang. So same is true pag MCL. No? Next is the dial test. No? Positive result is 10 degree difference. No? 10 degree difference compared sa other food. So same sa PLC, no? You listen, ha? Kapag you do it at 90 degrees, no, parang yung nasa picture, no? You do it at 90 degrees, positive ka. Pag 90 degrees, you are testing the PCL and the PLC. At 90, ha? At 90 degree, you are testing the PCL and the PLC. Kapag you're doing it at 30, you are testing the PLC lang, no? Isolated PLC. Laging ganun, no? If you want to isolate something, you do it at 30. So, kapag negative ka sa 90, positive ka sa 30, ibig sabihin you have injury of the PLC. Kapag positive ka sa 90, positive ka sa 30, ibig sabihin combined PCL-PLC. So, lagi nilang tinatanong sa exam, di ba? Imaging modality of choice. Kapag nabasa nyo, avascular necrosis, occult fracture, MRI. Involves the application of strong magnetic fields and excitation radio frequency pulses to the patient. No? So, this is the PCL. Again, yung lumabas last year, insertion. No? And this is a MRI appearance of your ACL. Coronal, that's the ACL. Lumabas nung panahon namin, they showed a picture something like this. So if this is the left knee, what is the structure on the upper right? Kung yan yung left knee. Structure at pointer. That's the medial meniscus, di ba? The one below, that's the lateral meniscus. So of course, that's the ACL. And I want you to memorize this, no? So, yung lumabas noong 2023, ang tanong, 6 mm ba o 3 mm? 3 mm chondral defect daw. Ano daw yung gagawin mo dun sa chondral defect na yon? So, isinama ko na lang yun sa next lecture, no? Pero, you can know the treatment by knowing the classification. Huh? Okay, so that's the last slide. Okay. Carlos, paano stop? So, if you want to test the AM bundle, what test will you do? Lock.